Appreciate it. How many Lee Brown fans we got out here tonight? I knew it. I don't think I'll be playing Lee Brown tonight, but now that I don't like him, I'm just saying. That's an inside joke between me and a young lady about 2 rows in, right in the middle, wearing all gray, dark hair. In case y'all are wondering, she's covering her face right now. She's got a pink phone. Show off with tonight, and Sean's like, why don't you go out there and play one by yourself? I was like, cool, I'll do that. And as I stood there playing all these songs, I was like, I get brushed up on to kick the show off tonight. Every song I started playing, Sean's like, oh wait, I know that one, I can play that one, don't play that one. So I was like, okay, I'll try this one. He's like, oh wait, don't play that one either. So ladies and gentlemen, I believe I'm gonna kick this show off with the same thing I did last year. It kind of concerns me because he's had an entire year to learn this song. He's okay with me playing this without him. Memories stayed and when you left, and I tried to do my best to move on like you said, but my heart wouldn't let me rest. So I occupy my time with all that I could find to leave you far behind. Nothing worked now. I'm painting pictures on the canvas of my mind. You're still with me, using the lines on my poor heart like a paint by numbers guide to what used to be. And now brush can heal the past, cause every color brings you back. When I feel like I'm off track and I hurt so bad, then I'm painting pictures on the canvas of my mind. You're still with me, using the lines on my poor heart like a paint by. Painting pictures.
Ooh, it's hot. I got it in Alaska. I figured it was gonna be warm enough for tonight. I didn't figure out that it'd go the other way too. This is warm. Maybe I'm just nervous. I don't know. I know a bunch of folks in the crowd, so it could be that too. Usually I played a bunch of strangers. I'm alright with that, but you guys know me. Y'all are judgmental. I might see y'all in church or something. You suck. Where at?
Knott's Grove.
Knott's Grove, yes sir. I spent some time out there. I said that like it was a prison. Y'all hear that? All I gotta do is tap tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, this fella right here is from Geneva, New York, and he's one of my best friends. He is currently residing in Nashville, because I can't talk him into moving to North Carolina, but you know, you guys, you don't realize how good we got it out here. So, that's right. Yes, I do. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mr. Sean Smith, everybody.
Thank you. You got this guitar up there? Because I don't have it up here. But it sounds pretty.
I think that's one of those quiet guitars.
It is.
It is.
So far, it's still muted.
That's fine to me.
They were birds and planes and rocks and...
What'd you do? Work a minute ago.
Is it muted?
That channel might be muted, maybe. Comment. When they figured this out the sound check, you got them. I love that song, though. Is that Tom Petty?
Yep.
You wrecked me, baby. You wrecked me, girl. Y'all don't realize the guitar part he's playing is really intricate, but it's awesome.
Yeah, it sounds great up here. We're close.
You know, we don't need it. Everybody just gather around. Are you plugged in?
Yeah, I'm plugged in.
I wasn't blaming you.
It's probably muted, so if you're messing with it, this would really be the only thing I can imagine. There's a switch on a DI there, so.
Not a smart man.
I heard that.
Ladies and gentlemen, we got a brand new single that's going to be coming out. I'm going to be making some announcements tonight, and I hope they're okay with the people that I text and said, is it okay that I make that announcement, but nobody texts me back. So we're going to make some announcements tonight, and there's some pretty cool stuff coming down. We're hoping to have the new website up in about 3 weeks, maybe. We got a new single that's going to be on iTunes. I'm going to guess within the next 3 weeks as well. It's going to be uploaded to iTunes, so you'll be able to download it, everybody. We can also announce that for everybody who helped with our Kickstarter program, you guys helped make our record. So we appreciate that, you guys, for helping be a part of our record label. And that means that you can stop asking me when it's going to come out, because for the last 6 months, 8 months, I've been telling people, oh, next month. And the reason I kept pushing off is because we just signed a distribution deal with a company out of Mississippi, and that's why we've been waiting so long to make the announcement, having to get all the contracts and lawyers and everything else out of the way, but we're finally done with it. So you guys are the first people to hear this. We signed the distribution deal that can possibly put us into Walmart as an independent artist. That's pretty cool. And we're excited about that. And we're looking at a May 5th release, so it's going to be out in May. I'm pretty excited about that. So you guys are the first people to hear that. So again, I hope that was okay with the people that I texted and asked if it was okay if I said that, but nobody answered me, so it's on them. Ladies and gentlemen, here's a new single we just told you about, a song called God Only Knows.
Yeah.
shoulder, letting whiskey speak for me. Well, you packed your bags, and when you look back, I sat and watched you go. What was I thinking? God only knows how much I love you. What I'd give for a second chance. I swallowed my pride, stay by your side, never let it go again. And I don't know if you don't come back, I'll make it on my own. What was I thinking? God only knows what's on your mind every time my number's on your phone.
Somebody got a little something special. That's what happens when y'all let me talk.
Sounds like this.
Why does mine sound like this?
It ain't good.
A friend of mine came over to the house the other day and he picked up a guitar. He said, I said, man, I'm not sure that's in tune. He said, it's in A tune. All right.
Touché.
me.
Yeah.
Make it harder for you to sing when I do that.
Help me.
I think he's talking to y'all.
It's where I grew. the sound. Amazing grace.
I usually like to tell a story how I grew up around here. I grew up off of 82 acre tobacco farm out there in Wilton, North Carolina. Richard Wheeler's farm. We did this show at South Granville a couple years ago, and Richard Wheeler and his family were there, so it was kind of cool being able to tell stories and them look at me knowing that every one of them was true. By the time I learned how to drive, I think I told this story out there. My dad actually taught me how to drive a stick on the farm. And he let me drive this 82 Toyota we used to have. And I remember one Saturday, he was out on visitation. My dad was a preacher over there at Temple Baptist Church on Highway 15. And I remember he and at Knott's Grove for a while.
Woo!
But I remember I went inside. My mom was having a ladies' fellowship that day. The last place that a young teenage boy wants to be, well, might be the first place he wants to be. I don't know. Maybe I was thinking wrong. But it's in a house full of ladies. And I said, Mom, can I take the truck out and go driving? It was raining that day. And she said, your dad let you drive the truck? I said, yeah. She said, all right, be careful. And I went down there, and I flew down that path. I mean, it's muddy, and I was sliding. I was having a good old time. And I went out on the path right beside the pond, and I got thrown down in third gear and just decided to take it up a little further. And the back end started sliding out from underneath me. I was like, where am I going? Right into the pond. Yep. It was either a 45-foot embankment off this side and this, or falling to the pond this way. I figured I could get it out of the pond easier, but honestly, looking back on it, I think maybe if I'd have hit the 45-foot embankment, when Dad asked where his truck was later on, I'd be like, I don't know. You couldn't see down there from the house. Yeah, that was fun. Sean, you tell some stories about growing up.
I got nothing on that. Exactly.
Thank God this ain't a church, Marie.
Oh, God. Mama.
I wonder who was that. Ladies and gentlemen, we haven't played this song in forever, right? Sean just requested it, and we actually, I saw a bunch of requests come in this week on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter and all that stuff. You can follow us at jasonmichaelcarroll.com, facebook.com, jasonmichaelcarroll, Instagram, jasonmichaelcarroll, and Twitter, at JMCOfficial. I used to tell people I didn't give a twit, and now I can't say that. A while back, probably almost 6 years ago, for the first time ever, one of the things I want to check off my bucket list when I got in a band was I wanted to play the North Carolina State Fair. And that day, a friend of mine named Patrick Davis, who wrote the last song that I played, Where I'm From, he was out on the bus with me, and we were writing some songs that week, and we were sitting out there, and it was the night we played the fair. It was pouring down rain all day long. Nobody could ride nothing. People were shivering and cold. But I was still excited to be there. I was so excited. And I remember Patrick and I sat in the back of the bus that day because we couldn't go riding on the rides or eat cotton candy or nothing. I guess we could have done that. But anyway, we started this song. We finished it about 2.5 hours right there at the North Carolina State Fair. And I love this song. And hope, and we had a lot of requests for it. So here's a song called My Fair.
Baby, just lay there. Don't you move, and I will lay right here watching you. I wonder if you know how much I love just having you in my life. Cause you're my to hide when Just 1 minute more, that's all I ask. I want to picture you looking just like that. T-shirt and hair down, no makeup on. Girl, I'm constantly amazed how beautiful you are. Cause you're my favorite thing to hold when the world is running round. You're my favorite place to hide when the rain is pouring down. And I wish that I could find the perfect verse, the perfect rhyme. But I guess all I'm saying is any way you say it, baby, you're my favorite. There ain't no doubt about it, cause you're my favorite thing to hold when the world is running round. You're my favorite place to hide when the rain is pouring down. And I wish that I could find the perfect verse, the perfect rhyme. But I guess all I'm really saying, cause I love you so much, baby. And any way you say it, baby, you're my favorite.
We haven't played that one in a couple of years, maybe.
We haven't. We haven't played that one in a while. Wow.
We got a lot of them.
We do.
Remember that time we got?
Oh, yeah.
I do.
He didn't write that. I'm just kidding.
Thanks a lot, Sean. Some of that might not have been. Ladies and gentlemen, the Peanut Gallery just chimed in and just reminded me that we've got a guy over here selling our Cracker Barrel CD. We got the Numbers record. This may be one of the last times we're selling that CD at shows. We've got the new one coming out May 5th. Did I say May 5th? I did say May 5th. The record is called What Color Is Your Sky? And so I'm pretty excited about that one. It's a song that is on the record. We might as well play that one now, right? Just maybe. Ladies and gentlemen, this song is a song that I wrote, and I actually wrote it. It came from an inspiration. The inspiration was from a fight I had on Facebook. I won't go into the story, but she was wrong.
When you live, I know I say it.
You know when the worst time to get a frog in your throat is?
Oh.
Right in.
Yeah, that's tough. Yeah.
My goodness, ladies and gentlemen, we're out here tonight for our third year in a row. I did that, but I meant that. For our third year in a row, being a part of this event to bring awareness to families living violence free, because a lot of families are not. And you guys showing up tonight, violence hit, hanging out with us for a little bit. You guys are the ones doing it all. So thank y'all very much for coming out here and being a part of it. It's something that needs a lot more attention. And you guys are bringing that tonight, so thank you very much for that. Back in Creedmoor, I remember we were driving around, going back and forth to the airport, and I've told this story several times, but going back and forth to the airport when I lived there, and seeing the signs on the side of the road that said, "Pray for Kelly," you know? And I remember seeing those signs and what they meant to me, you know, and just it was such a, we're a small community, you know, out there, and Granville County, it seems like a big place, but I promise you, North Granville knows what South Granville's doing, and it's just how things roll. And, you know, this thing affected more than just Granville County. It affected the surrounding areas, too. I mean, the searches were everywhere. People were volunteering from everywhere. And I remember seeing the community come together in ways where every morning I'd get up and go to the airport, like at 5:30 in the morning, and driving to the airport, I'd say a prayer for Kelly on the way there. And, you know, for Pat and Juanita and then their family to put this thing on every year to be a part of this with families living violence free, I can't thank you guys enough for what y'all are doing to bring awareness to something that I know affected you guys in a way that is just tremendous. So thank you guys for what y'all do. Somebody's gone for whatever reason it is, and you lose somebody from this world, and you start thinking, and I know you've all said it, I've said it, but you start telling people, and you hear people say it all the time, man, they were gone too soon, you know, and usually what follows that is something along the lines of, if they were still here, they'd be doing great things, you know? I got to thinking about that one day, and I got to thinking about if they meant as much to us as we say they do, and I'm not doubting that, but I'm saying that we need to approach it differently. If they meant as much to us as we say they do, then we should do something in their honor to make every day better. If they were that kind of person, then you should do something for them to continue that legacy, to continue what they would have done. And I believe that that's what Pat and Juanita are doing with this event every year. Families Living Violence Free, I think that's what they're doing. And here's a song, ladies and gentlemen, called Waste Their Life.
We hear every time someone has died, then they live this whole world way too early. If they were still here, they'd spend their years begging it. Sorrow No, it won't bring you back. And we're still gonna cry. For every good deed done in love, we take away their life. Those that are gone, and if they were all up there just watching, would they recognize the good in my life, or would they be ashamed that they could be? And it weighs on my mind.
Love, 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 love so I
spending way too long checking my tongue in the mirror and bending over backwards just to try to see it clearer. But my breath fogged up the glass, so I drew a face and I laughed. I guess all I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to rid yourself of vanity. Just go with the season, it's what we aim to do. Our name is our virtue, but I won't hesitate no more, no more. This is our fate. How yours? Open up your eyes and see like me. Open up your plans and dare your dreams. Look into your heart and you'll find the sky.
There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never
touch of your hand says you'll catch me ever I fall. Yeah, you say it best when you say nothing at all.
We were just singing that song here, and I remember I might have actually done the Alison Krauss part if you guys want to laugh at me for a swing. But Dan and Murray Jackson right here, these folks right here in the second row. We were out here, how many years ago was that? Probably 10? I'm going to say at least 10 years ago, right? Maybe 11. I'm not willing to go, what? It was 2004?
10 years ago.
So, I'm out there with my friend David. We got invited to the lake. Shoot, yeah. There's a couple rednecks from this neck of the woods. I'm like, all right, we'll go. So we went up to Carr Lake to hang out. Dan and Marie had a lake house up there. So we're like, all right, we're going to go up there and party with everybody. And we ain't been invited to the lake much, so we weren't really sure how to act. But, can we hold our pinkies out? I'm not sure. I'm not joking. But most water I saw was on the pond on the farm I grew up on, so they had bass in there. So we're out there, and at the end of the night, you know, we're out there taking the boats across the lake and listening to music and inner tubing. We're having a great old time. And at the end of the day, you know, it got too cold to be in the water, so we're out there. I think my sunburn was kicking in, actually, but anyway, we sit around a campfire that night out there in the backyard, and I remember all their neighbors came over. I mean, it was probably 30 people out there, don't you think?
It was like five.
It started with five, and then it was about, yeah. So it was a ton of people, and I remember David and I, we had acoustic guitars, and we just started playing. It felt like the right thing to do. You give us a campfire and a couple of acoustic guitars and some beer. There was a couple of them, too. And we wound up having a good old time. And I remember we had a request for Garth Brooks. Somebody said, play some Garth Brooks. All right, cool. So I'm a huge Garth Brooks fan. I love Garth Brooks. I do. I'm a huge fan. Get this. I've spoken to Garth twice on the phone. I've got a voicemail from him. I've never met him.
Carol?
It'll happen one day. But so, anyway, back to my story. We're up there and we're having a good old time. And I remember David just started kicking into, we played Alan Jackson, played all kinds of stuff, and then he started playing Garth Brooks. He started playing the Thunder Rolls. 3:30 in the morning, not a soul in sight. His city's looking like a ghost town on a moonlit summer night. The rain drops on the windshield, there's a storm moving in. He's heading back from somewhere that he never should be. And the thunder rolled. And as soon as I said that, the loudest clap of thunder came, and it scared the hell out of me. But it felt like God was cheering me on. So we didn't stop. We kept playing it. But I swear, it was on point. What do you want to hear? Woo! I'm going to tell you. That was funny. Facebook didn't exist then, but somebody would have been filming that, and we'd have had a blast of that. That was amazing. You know, I'm not lying. Yeah. Greg and Cicely were there, and Dan and Marie were there, and yeah, Dave will tell you, I mean, it scared the hell out of me. It did. I had to go jump in the lake. I did later, that was another reason.
Feeling nostalgic now.
Are you really?
Trying not to do songs that we did last year, you know, all the songs we did.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah, sure. This is a song off my first record. Now, this is actually going to be my first single. It was going to be my first single on my first record. People don't know that. People think Alyssa Lies was our first single. That was not our first single, believe it or not.
Wrong.
I got you. A chicken. So, I remember people thought This Loud was our first single, and it was really ironic how this came about, but the first single that the record label chose was a song on my first record called Looking at You. And I remember that we went to the radio stations for about 6 weeks, and we were out there shopping the song, you know, playing it for radio stations. They'd spin it off the record so that we get the spin, and it's technical stuff. And then they said, well, can you play one live for us? And we played List of Lies everywhere we went. And about 6 weeks into the radio tour, people were going nuts saying, Jason, I actually had the label call me, so we thought we had a plan for this, but we're going to switch gears. We're going to go with List of Lies as your first single. But by that point, we'd already had it out for 6 weeks. But now get this. People don't realize it. Within that 6 weeks' time, we went to Phoenix, Arizona. And I remember, not North Dakota. I don't even know there's Phoenix, North Dakota. But in there, we went to Phoenix, Arizona. And while we're there, we decided the radio station there wanted us to play. They put together kind of different things. You've heard about radio stations. Hey, so-and-so's going to be playing at the roller skating rink. Come put your skates on and skate with, Gloriana or somebody. You know, that's just little fun things like that. Well, they decided this time, with Looking at You, my record rep put together this big idea. Looking at You, she bought a blow up sheep. I'm not gonna tell you what store she got it from, but it was that kind. And she wanted me to carry this into the radio stations. And I said no. And it was not it was just an inflatable animal. It was, yeah. I was not down with that. Not gonna happen. True story. And I remember, so she said, well, I got this other idea. We're going to go play at the Phoenix Zoo. I was like, cool, I've never been to the Phoenix Zoo. And she said, I got this idea for Looking at You, EWE. So we played in front of the petting zoo at the Phoenix Zoo. There was a guinea behind me that couldn't keep time for anything. And I swear the entire time we tried to sing, it was like, ah! And it was so hard, like, trying to keep meter in my head. And this guinea was behind me trying to join the band. I'm like, not now. But I swear, that's a true story. So here's our first single, everybody.
And some prefer a tropical view, and some like
but I like looking at you.
I have the words and I
bring her with every question that she asked, until I felt the tears roll down my face, and I told her that less of would be in store today. Cause she doesn't lie in the classroom, she doesn't lie anymore in school. Alyssa lies with Jesus, because there's nothing that anyone would do.
Hey, what's your name?
She's a fan. She's a stalker too, but she's a fan. And, she's one of those people that I know that she loves me. I do. She has a whole room dedicated to me at her house.
You know about that, huh?
It's all over her Instagram, huh?
I know. Because of him.
You know? It's a room. I have a room at your house. It's odd though, because she posted pictures on her Instagram this week of the room at her house. It's got autographs from me, pictures of me, and things like that from, you know, all the shows she's been to over the years. But right in the middle of the room, I'm on top of the chain. Tracy, come up here. Come here.
Oh God, no.
See, this is how things start. I say one birthday, you say it's your birthday. They say it's their birthday. Everybody says it's their birthday. Happy birthday to all y'all.
Hey, everybody else's
birthday.
Yes.
Come
on. I believe
you'll
be
like still.
Join me.
Hey, please.
Okay.
All right, here we go. Y'all don't even know what y'all just volunteered for. It's a dance off. Shorty had them apple bottom jeans. Woo! Nobody danced, man. I don't know what they did. Ladies and gentlemen, let's say happy birthday to them. So we're going to say happy birthday to y'all, because this is going to be three of them. It's going to be hard to do. I can do it, but it's going to be tough. All right. Happy birthday to y'all. Happy birthday to y'all. Happy birthday to all y'all.
I got everybody right.
Yeah.
And anybody else I missed? Y'all. Happy birthday to y'all. I stopped singing that song because that's all I knew. Shorty had been
apple. Sure.
I had a birth boot for the fur, that's all I got.
Yeah. That's why when I got in your car, I was playing.
I was getting ready for a birthday song. What note is that? It's an ABC.
Goodbye, and you took off your wedding ring.
done. All my friends keep trying to fix me up. Say I need somebody new. When it comes to love, I've all but given up.
Hey, you want to come up here and dance?
Is that a yes? I think that was a yes.
No. Boy, you're a grounder. YouTube video is doing it.
Birds in the trees. talking about my girl. I've got sunshine on a cloudy day.
Oh, wait, I missed the verse, didn't I?
I don't know.
I think it is.
This is where we fell apart last time.
I think it might be.
It's on YouTube.
It is. I think we fell apart on YouTube. Damn. You're so close.
We're a long way from Motown. I need to freshen up on that.
But you know, if you would have done the move I told you to do, we would have got through this a whole lot easier. I'm just saying.
I'm wearing the wrong suit.
I need the inspiration. I need to get it.
I wore the wrong suit for that.
Remember that movie? What happened to the rehearsal?
Stand by me.
see how I hit that note? I was so sure that was it. I swear. I was like, oh, I got it this time.
It was really close.
That was even further off.
It was the right string. Never had one lesson.
Only six.
Yeah. Your odds are pretty good.
Yeah, the odds are pretty good. Yeah. Odds are not ever in my favor. The Hunger Games people got their own sleep. Oh, we have to announce a raffle. So they're going to be raffling off a guitar in a little bit. So everybody got the raffle tickets? Everybody going to get one? Did you get a raffle ticket? Did you get a raffle? You did.
Oh,
like,
here.
You did not.
Here, I got a number for you to read to. I have
one.
I have a guitar.
Two. Why are there so many songs about rainbows? I'm telling you, man, if you don't play something, I'm gonna just there's gonna tell where I'm gonna go.
Well, I was saying I thought maybe they were gonna do a raffle. I want to make sure we got before they wanted to do it before you were done.
Oh.
So that's, you know, I don't know if they want to do that now or another time.
What time do we start? I love that song.
There are stars in the southern sky.
She's lost that loving feeling.
No, she doesn't.
Yes, she has.
I hate that she does that.
He said, I love you till I die. She told him you're forgetting time. As the years went slowly by, she still preyed upon his mind. He kept her pictures on his wall. Went half crazy now and then. He still loved her through it all, hoping she'd come back again. He kept some letters by his bed, dated 1962. He had underlined in red, every single I love you. I went to see him just today. Oh, but I didn't see no tears. All dressed up to go away. First time I'd seen him smile again.
You know, she came to see me just one last time. Oh, and we all wanted to see her. But you know, the thought kept running through my mind. This time, I'm going to forget it.
Peace out, loving hearts, today. least I've a loving heart today. At least I've a loving heart today. They place a wreath upon his door, and soon they'll carry him away. At least I've a loving heart.
In this building, they're a lot prettier than us, but there's a bunch of y'all sitting out there too.
But you have a fan who told me a story of everywhere you go, he brings you something down or an art, and I think he laid it down. So on behalf of the fan, he's getting his Dale Earnhardt.
He didn't lay it down. He gave it to me, and my wife laid it down.
So I laid it down, and I delivered.
Hey, Junior. You knew where it was? She was going to go back and get it. Junior, come here, buddy. Come here, green hat.
Okay.
It's not hard finding him.
Can everybody see their tickets? Okay, you have 1 in 788 chances of walking away with that guitar tonight. So whoever wins needs to leave here and buy a Powerball. Okay, this is Peyton Brown. She is North Carolina Outstanding Miss. She doesn't have a crown on. But I figured she didn't know anybody in this room. She didn't. She knew the number, though. So I'm gonna let her pull the number out. So let's go. Here it is.
One, one, two, two, six, six.
One, one, two, two. Six, six.
I can remember that.
B. One.
It might have been the ones I lost.
What? No, you don't.
Yeah!
I am so excited because she told me right before this, she said if she won, I got to get the guitar.
can still feel so much pain. Like a knife that cuts right through me, but that scar
start the show, and I remember I saw her walk in, and I was like, hold a minute, guys, I'll be right back. And I jumped off the stage, which is really impressive because it was like a 4.5-foot stage. It was in Greensboro, and I mean, it was a huge stage. I about twisted my ankle when I jumped, but I remember I went out there, and I walked up to her, and I hugged her, and I said, hey, it's so good to see you. I said, I'm sorry things went the way they did. I think about you all the time. I still love you. You never have to speak to me again. I just had to get this off my chest. I remember I got on stage that night and my guitar player had made the set list for that evening. And the set list, the very first song in our set was Kenny Chesney's Just Don't Have It Twice. And it was ironic because she stuck around. We started talking. My keyboard player made some obscene comments to her after the show, which really made me feel like part of the band. And I was thinking if she wasn't gone then, she is now. And so I wrote this song about her, and I don't get to tell that story often because she's not in a lot of the shows, but she's right there beside our little star son in the green hat. And she cries at commercials, so she's probably crying right now, but I can't see. So, but I did write this song for her. Years later, it became a friend of mine's favorite song. After we wrote it on the road while we were out from pushing Alyssa Lives across the country, and we're in California. I wrote this song, and I remember when we wrote it, we felt so powerful about it that we sang it at the next radio station we went to, and our record label rep freaked, and she's calling Nashville, and she's like, "You gotta hear this new song you wrote. I know the middle of the record, but you gotta get this song on the record." So then they called me and said, "Jason, when you get back to Nashville, everybody's loving this song. You're going back in the studio to cut it." So we went to Nashville, we cut it. The next week we were playing at Boone, North Carolina. My friend Brittany Coppedge came to that show. She was going to school at Lee's McCray right outside of App State. And I remember she came to the show, and I just got an email from my producer saying, "Hey, here's the finished track." And I said, "Hey, come here." So Brittany and I went to the back of the bus, and I put it on the stereo back there. She sat with me, and I played the song for her. A week later, her friends are telling me, "You've got to play something else because she's driving us crazy singing this song." And I remember we played the Children's Hospital, which was another check on my bucket list that I always wanted to do for the QDR. Concert for kids that they do every year at the North Carolina Children's Hospital. And that's something that I grew up hearing on the radio. It's something I always wanted to be a part of, and here we were playing it. And I remember Brittany came that day, she had a doctor's appointment, and we played this song in the hospital lobby, and she stood kind of right over there by the door, and I remember she sang along with us, and she went and had her appointment that day. Well, we were Christmas shopping a little while back, about a week or two after that, and I got a voicemail from Brittany's mom in one of the stores we were in. I guess my phone didn't work. I remember I stepped outside, and I remember I checked my voicemail, and Wendy was walking with me, and I remember I just started shaking, and I started crying. And I remember Wendy asked me, "What's wrong?" And I said, "Tammy says that Brittany has cancer." So we drove to North Carolina Children's Hospital to visit Brittany. The very last show that she came to and saw me play was at the Children's Hospital. It was why that show means so much to me every year. Why I want to be a part of that every year. We lost Brittany. Brittany was diagnosed on December 3rd. We lost her on December 28th. Very aggressive cancer. To this day, every time we play this song right here, I send it out to my friend Brittany Coppedge. You can find out more about Brittany and her story at brittanysbattle.org.
Yeah!
Jason, Mike, and Carol, thank y'all very much for having us out here and supporting such a great cause. Here's to another year of families in the Valley Street. Thank y'all for having us.